Let's see how to add and remove users in MySQL using MySQL Workbench. Let's start by opening MySQL Workbench. To make changes to users, we must log in as root. I click here to log in as the root user. Let's provide the root password. And voila, we are now logged in as root. Next, I click on the Users and Privileges option. And let's start by removing a user. So here is the user we want to remove. I click on it and then I simply click on Delete. We need to confirm the deletion of this account. And just like that, this user is now removed and no longer exists. Let's now see how to create a new user. To do this, I click on Add Account. We need to provide a login name for the new user. For the authentication type, I'll select Standard. And then we need to provide a password. Let's confirm the password by retyping it. In the Account Limits tab, we can limit the new account. For example, we can set a limit to the number of queries this user can run. But for this demonstration, I don't want to impose any of these limits, so I leave these settings untouched. However, we do need to adjust the schema privileges. Here, we can determine which databases this user will have access to. We can choose specific databases or grant this user access to all databases. To do that, we click on Add Entry. If we want to give the new user access to all databases, we select the All Schema option. If we only want to allow access to specific databases, we'll select the Selected Schema option, and then choose the specific database we want the user to access. In my case, I only want to give the user access to this specific database, so I'll choose it, and then we need to click on OK. We can see that the selected database has been added to the list, but right now the user has no privileges. So the next step is to decide which privileges we want this user to have on this database. In my case, I want this user to have all privileges on this database, so I click on Select All. Now we can see all the privileges that this user will have on this database. To actually create the user, we click on Apply. And that's basically it. The user was created, and we can see them in the list. Let's now close the root session. And let's log in as the new user. I click here to create a new connection. Let's give a name to this new connection. And for the username, I'll input the new user we just created. Let's click on OK to confirm. Now let's use this new connection to log in as the new user. We need to provide its password. Then click on OK. And we're now logged in as the new user. If we open the Schemas tab, we can see that this user only has access to the specific database we selected. Within this database, it has all privileges. However, it has no privileges on and cannot see any of the other databases.